The first step in the care of cuts, scrapes, abrasions, is to stop the bleeding. Most wounds respond to direct pressure with a clean cloth or bandage. Hold the pressure continuously for approximately 10 to 20 minutes. If this fails to stop the bleeding or if bleeding is rapid, seek medical assistance. Next, thoroughly clean the wound with soap and water. Remove any foreign material in the wound, such as dirt or bits of grass, which may lead to infection. Tweezers can be used. Clean them with alcohol first to remove foreign material from the wound edges, but do not dig into the wound as this may push bacteria deeper into the wound or injure subcutaneous, under the skin, structures. The wound may also be gently scrubbed with a washcloth to remove dirt and debris. Hydrogen peroxide and povidone-iodine, betadine, products may be used to clean the wound initially, but may inhibit wound healing if used long-term. Cover the area with a bandage, such as gauze or a band-aid, to help prevent infection and dirt from getting in the wound. A first aid antibiotic ointment, bacitracin, neosporin, polysporin, can be applied to help prevent infection and keep the wound moist. Continued care to the wound is also important. 3 times a day, wash the area gently with soap and water, apply an antibiotic ointment, and recover with a bandage. Change the bandage immediately if it gets dirty or wet. If you cannot control the bleeding from a cut or scrape, abrasion, seek medical attention. Any cut that goes beyond the top layer of skin or is deep enough to see into might need stitches, sutures, and should be seen by a doctor as soon as possible. Generally, the sooner the wound is sutured, the lower the risk of infection. Ideally, wounds should be repaired within 6 hours of the injury. People with suppressed immune systems, including people with diabetes, cancer patients receiving chemotherapy, people who take steroid medications, such as prednisone, patients on dialysis, or people with HIV, are more likely to develop a wound infection and should be seen by a doctor. People who are on blood-thinning medication and cannot control the bleeding should be seen by a doctor immediately. Any wound that shows signs of infection should be seen by a doctor.